name's Annette Macias. I'm also the executive director for Love, Inc. of Greater Merced. Love, Inc. means love in the name of Christ. We are not an agency or an organization. We are a faith-driven ministry of Merced. So Merced means mercy. And some of the ways that we can show mercy to our community is to come alongside and to bring hope. The need is great in Merced. And one of our greatest needs is the client who comes to us who is a single mom and is struggling to make ends meet. We go into their homes and they have no beds for their children and their children are sleeping on the floor. They don't have the extra income to purchase the things that they need because they are trying to pay their rent and to just get by. So we are a clearinghouse for the churches. And what that means is that when the clients call, we qualify them for their particular need. And then if they need furniture, we will set them up with a home visit. We go to their home with a volunteer and we pray for them and we assess their need. So oftentimes we come out that we recognize that the spiritual need is far greater than the physical need. And so we bring a volunteer and the volunteer will pray for the client and start to have a spiritual conversation with them. We also help with medical transportation and appointments, baby formula, diapers, and baby items. We also have toiletries, household items, blankets, linens, holiday meals, and Thanksgiving meals. We also offer the Love Plus program. What's wonderful about this program is we come alongside with a mentor and we teach them about budgeting. We teach them about nutrition, about decision making, about knowing God, and we walk alongside them in their journey. And at the 17 weeks, when it's all done, we celebrate their accomplishments. Our greatest needs for material items are beds and dressers. That's what we get requested for the most. But really, one of our greatest needs is for prayer. We need you to come alongside and help pray for the ministry of Love in the name of Christ. And second, to volunteer. Love Inc. would cease to exist without the volunteers in the churches. So if you had a couple hours to give, that you could be on the phones, that you could stuff envelopes, that you could give a ride to somebody, that you could be a mentor in our Love Plus program, there's all kinds of needs that could be filled by bringing your talent and who you are. And so will you join us, Love Inc., Love in the Name of Christ, in meeting some of those needs? Would you volunteer a couple hours? Would you volunteer to pray for our ministry? Whatever you can do, Love in the Name of Christ. Thank you.
Hey.
Hi, welcome.
How's it going, everybody? My name is Pastor Jake, and
I'm Sabrina Rayford, and I am the Clearinghouse Coordinator with Love in the Name of Christ of Merced.
Awesome. And we are going to be your host this evening. I'm excited to be here with all of you as I am taking a look at the feeds. I see people already commenting. Hi, Leslie. Thanks for being here. We got Jackie here. Thank you so much. We also have Kathy Rayford, who's here with us in the chats. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate you, and it is our pleasure to hang out with you tonight. And there is a couple things. One, first, we want to say that we really want to give you some information that is very important for you to know. So let's dive in. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. So did you know that Love Inc. started out as a movement over 40 years ago for local churches to come together to network? Because of the great need in our community, Love Inc.'s network of resources, skills, and volunteers help provide for people and themselves and for their families. The Merced branch started in 1991, and as of 2020, this year, we have a total of 32 mobilized churches that have partnered with Love Inc. and have come to stand together in Christ with Love Inc. and their own community. And so before we move in, we want to also just let you know what mobilizing the church means. We feel strongly that God has called us to not just go to church, but to be the church. And we have 32 churches who have come alongside Love Inc. and have said, we want to help that happen. So that's what mobilizing the church looks like. So we just want to acknowledge that we've been here since 1991 and we have 32 partner churches. Won't you tell us a little bit more about the mission of Love Inc.?
So at Love Inc., our mission is to mobilize churches to transform lives and communities in the name of Christ. Love Inc. of Greater Merced serves the communities of Merced, Atwater, Planada, Winton, and Le Grand. Within those communities, we have 32 churches partnered that provide resources to people in need and volunteer assistance. Mm. Love Inc. serves as a liaison among individuals, agencies, organizations, and churches who desire to reach out and serve those in need.
Praise God.
Together, we come alongside those individuals and families of who have multiple needs but desire to break free from the cycle of poverty. Our services include food, furniture, appliances, holiday assistance, deliveries, baby items, personal care products, and so much more.
Oh my gosh, that's so much. And if you didn't know, now you know, right? Love Inc. provides so much for its community. Really quick, hi Jackie Simmons, thank you for praying for us. Thank you for being with us. Lee, thank you. We're so glad that you can join us. Thank you for being in prayer with us as well. I think I saw a little earlier in the comments, a lady named Irene, I think it is. Irene, thank you. We're so happy that you're here. Beatrice, you as well. We are excited. And what I'm doing is I'm actually showing you how you can engage with us tonight. This is live. Bree and I can see your comments. We can see what you're saying. And so right now, from where you're at, please just put like a heart emoji, a thumbs up emoji, a high five. We want to hear, flood the chats. We want to know you're here. So why don't you tell them a little bit about how they can donate if they were eager to do so already?
So there are a couple of ways that you can donate at any time, even right now. So one way that you can donate is our text to give, and that's at 41444. Or you can go to our website at Love Inc. Merced and go to the donate tab and donate. I just want to encourage you to just if you feel like you just want to make a difference in our community, just go ahead and donate. Every yes. penny, every dollar counts. It makes a difference in someone's life.
Yes.
Someone who's in need, someone who has without. And if you are in a place where you can make a donation today, we encourage you and we thank you.
Oh, so good. So good. Hi, Christy. Love it. We got our neighbor right here in the house. Thank you for saying hi. Well, here's something fun. We started off with some information, right, about there'll be some questions that are coming up, basically, is what I'm saying. And again, there will not be one, but two giveaways during tonight's event. So we'll be asking you to answer those questions that relate to Love Inc. And the first person to answer those correctly in the comment sections will win a prize. And so we want to give you some helpful tips to be able to kind of help with the auction, as well as kind of keep going with the comments and follow us along. We want to give that helpful tip for them.
Yes.
Stumbling over my words right now.
It's okay. So you can have two tabs or windows open for tonight. Have the event on one and then have the auction bidding site on another. Feel free to comment and message. Our response team is in need of our help throughout tonight's online event. So not only will we be engaging with you, but also we have a support team who is on the back end that is also answering your questions. So please feel free to direct message us on our Facebook page and our team will get right back to you shortly.
Awesome. Now we have a short video message from some of our local pastors and our partner churches.
Hi, I'm L. Scott. I'm one of the pastors at Gateway Church, and it's my privilege to recommend Love Inc. to you. Back a number of years ago, before Love Inc. got started, a lot of us pastors had the same people coming from door to door to door to door, pretty much the same stories, but sometimes just abusing the help that we were willing to give. So much so that we started getting a burnout feeling, and we were concerned that some of the people who truly deserved and needed the help weren't going to be able to get helped. So we had heard about Love in the Name of Christ being formed in chapters in different cities around and decided to try to get a chapter going here. Once Love Inc. was started here, it became even better than we had hoped. What we were hoping for was kind of a clearinghouse so that we could help the truly needy while not being sucked into some of the stories of the people who are just manipulating the good hearts and good feelings of a lot of folks. Well, Love Inc. has done so much more than that. It has become a wonderful clearinghouse for us to vet the needs of the people who come to us. But it's also become a ministry staffed by people who've developed expertise, have huge amounts of compassion, and have worked towards truly giving people not just a handout, but a hand up, as often is referred to. And it's become a group that a ministry really not just for Merced, but loving of Merced. It's by the churches, it's by the people who get working together to truly try to bring the love of Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus Christ to the people of this area. And some of the programs that have been developed, like Love Plus and some of the food distribution and furniture distribution and so on, have gone so far beyond just the initial clearinghouse kind of work. So it's just become a ministry that has been developed with wisdom, with great insight, and with great compassion, with truly the love of Jesus Christ. And I encourage you to support this ministry, a ministry of all the churches and Christian individuals of the Merced area. It's probably one of the best ways that you can invest in truly helping our neighbors. And of all the times when it's needed, probably no time like today. So please, please consider giving your prayer support, giving your financial support, encouraging people to volunteer. Wonderful ministry. And to all of you involved with Love Inc., thank you so much for loving Merced and this whole area in the name of Christ.
Hi, my name is Pastor Craig, and these are some of my friends who helped me move furniture for Love in the Name of Christ. Listen, we love Love Inc., and we just want to give you one message.
Please donate to Love in the Name of Christ.
On behalf of Love Inc., I'm Pastor Jeff Lease from Yosemite Church. I want to say thank you for participating in tonight's event. Love Inc. is an amazing partner in ministry. For 30 years, Yosemite Church has partnered with Love Inc. and they with us to meet people's needs. Way back then and now, I appreciate the fact that Love Inc. helps streamline resources. It takes the resource of every participating church and puts it directly to the need in the most expedient way. Secondly, I love the fact that Love Inc. screens the need. It can be challenging in ministry to legitimize the need that needs to be met. Love Inc. helps us do that. And thirdly, there's nothing better that the church could do than love in the name of Christ. I mean, that's what we're here for. So with me and with Love Inc., would you partner with us? Help us to love well, not just in word, but in deed, by literally delivering the resources to the need at hand. You can do that in a lot of ways. Maybe what God's blessed you with are resources and you can simply write a check. You can give financially. I want to encourage you, be a regular monthly supporter of Love Inc. Help us in this partnership with the churches of Merced and through Love Inc. to meet needs every single week. Secondly, maybe you've got time. Maybe God's blessed you with a few hours or a few minutes. Either way, you could participate in many of the different teams. You could help collect resources, or you could be on the side that delivers those resources. Each are a blessing. And when we together as the body of Christ participate, it makes me think of the Apostle Paul's prayer to the church in Philippi when he says, "I thank God every time I remember you because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now." I am so thankful that 30 years ago, on that first day, we began to partner with Love Inc. And still to this day, we get to do it now. Do it now with us. Choose to be a regular giver or a servant alongside others as we together in this community love in the name of Christ. God bless. Have a great evening. Hope to see you soon.
Wow. Hi. Welcome back. Thank you so much all the pastors that were able to come together for that video. That was so good. I actually can see that we have 52 households that are tuned in right now. All 52 of you, if you haven't already, do it again. Give us a like, a thumbs up, a heart. We want to see you participate. Leah, you're right. It's so good to see all the churches involved. Steve, love to see that little heart you're giving us. Love you, Steve. And what we're going to do right now is it's time to have a little fun. Are you excited?
I'm excited.
I'm excited. Why don't you tell them what we're going to do right now?
So right now we are going to do a giveaway. So what that means is not only is this a live auction, a live event that we're doing right now, plus a silent auction, we're also having a giveaway prize. So yay! So if you were listening in the beginning as we introduced ourselves and introduced what Love Inc. is about and our mission and our vision and everything, you would have heard some valuable information.
Yes.
And so I'm going to give you the first question, and then you would put in the comment section the answer to this. Okay, so here it is. Which year was Love Inc. in Merced founded?
Okay, there it is. What year was Love Inc. in Merced founded? On your mark, get set, go. Flood the feed right now. The first to answer correctly wins.
With you also what that giveaway is. That giveaway is from 510 Bistro, a gift card for you to enjoy a beautiful meal.
What? 510 Bistro is amazing. Oh my gosh. Rick, thanks for joining in. We've got Jane Chapman. Hello, hello. And man, they didn't even wait. Look, I think the very first answer we got is Chris Strength. You are correct. 1991. Good job. We got a few people who got it right.
Oh my gosh.
So we got Chris, Nadine, Michelle, Christy. Uh-huh. Good job.
Wow.
Yes. You are right. So many of you got it right. But Chris, you were the first to get it right. So a member of our team will reach out to you. But if all of you can, won't you chime in right now? Where are all of you joining us from? We're currently live at Gateway here in Merced, but we'd love to hear from you. Where are you from?
Merced here, we've been born and raised here in Merced, and so this has been our community here, and so it's a small town, but as you know, very hot. So where are you all from? Hawaii, or someone chimed in for Hawaii, from New York,
yes.
From, I don't know, from LA, from Bakersfield. Please let us know. We would love to see how far this virtual event is extending to. We are so grateful that we're able to do this in this way. As you know, we've always done it in a banquet setting. So we've been in a building. We've had tables where we've been able to just enjoy good food and then do our auctions. So share with us. Oh, it looks like Irene from Carmel.
Okay, Irene, little jealous, but that's okay. That's okay. Lori from Modesto, Michelle from McSwain. That's great. Keep flooding. Keep telling us where you're at. And while you do that, please stay tuned to also hear a few words from our executive director, Annette, who really wants to welcome you all to this evening's events.
Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us tonight for our first live virtual event. I heard a saying the other day that says, we are not all in the same boat, but we are in the same storm. Some of us are in boats that are stable with plenty of supplies. Some of us are in sailboats gliding over the waves. But for some of our neighbors, their rowboats are leaking and they can't plug up the holes fast enough. They have no supplies and they are adrift and lost at sea. So many of our loving families whose lives are a daily struggle, and that is before they had to deal with the pandemic. They are desperate for a lifeline, in need of being rescued. When COVID-19 hit our community, the phone began to ring with multiple requests for food, diapers, formula, and toiletries. Those who had never had to ask for food before were now requesting it for the very first time. An apartment complex with special needs adults had no way of getting food because their social workers were sheltered in place and had nowhere to turn. We began to mobilize the local churches and volunteers, and they stepped in and they stepped up to distribute food to those families in our community. We were seeing love in action, watching the body of Christ, throwing out a lifeline for those who were in crisis. It's always amazing to me to see how God invites us to join Him in His work. This past year, we were able to partner with First Baptist Church and give away 188 backpacks. We were able to equip and graduate 11 Love Plus participants in our Life Skills program. 100 children received $100 gift cards from Target, from our Sunrise Rotary for shoes and clothes, and 200 received Christmas gifts from our adoptive family. When the Contreras family called Love Inc. requesting assistance after their PG&E had turned off for 4 days, the husband could no longer work because he depended on electricity to do his job. The struggle had put a strain on their marriage and they were headed for divorce. They had lost hope in life and didn't know who could help. A donor heard their story and felt led to help the Contreras family. Not only were we able to get their PG&E turned back on, we also provided them with toiletries, a food box, a Visa card to buy their children Christmas gifts, and paid for their rent in January. When they left our office, after spending 2 hours talking and praying with us, their faith and hope in God was restored. Mother Teresa says, "We do not need to carry out grand things in order to show a great love for God and our neighbors. It is the intensity of love that we put into our gestures that makes them something beautiful for God. We are called to love God and love our neighbors. Every day I see people who have lost hope and who are disconnected from the love of God. We can bring hope and come alongside them with redemptive compassion to reveal the heart of the Father by being the hands and feet of Jesus to bring love in the name of Christ. One of the greatest gifts that we have is the gift of time. Our amazing volunteers have given so much time this past year. They have served over 6,000 hours last year for our ministry and our community. Love Inc. would cease to exist without the help of those hearts who desire to serve and give themselves away. Here's a quick video of some of our loving volunteers. We couldn't do it without them.
Hi, my name is Kathy, and I'm a volunteer for Love Inc. I've been volunteering for about 4 years. And the reason I volunteer is because Love Inc. does a lot for our community. Currently, they're supplying food for all the people that call in on a daily basis. So thank you for supporting the community and Love in the Name of Christ.
Hi, my name is Mona, and I've been a volunteer with Love Inc. for almost a year now. And one of our things is when people call in, they need food or toiletries and diapers. So we have diapers and we have wipes that we give to the families that are in need for things. And we have toiletries, we have shampoo, deodorant, shaving cream, razors for the men. It's just a joy to give to others. You know, it's better to give than to receive, I believe. A lot of our things, we help families with whatever they need. And thank everybody for all the donations that you give us, because then we can give to others. It's just been a pleasure working here and, you know, volunteering and helping with Love Inc. and all their things that they do. And if you ever want to volunteer, just call Love Inc. and we'll set it up where you can do it too. Okay? All right. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Jackie Tripp. I came to Love Inc. about 2 years ago after receiving a prayer from someone from Love Inc. needing help. I didn't know at the time who or what Love Inc. was about. But once I got here, it was great to see how these people could come together with other churches and be able to support the community as well as they do. My job here, because it's my gift, is bookkeeping. I make sure that the money flow comes in, gets posted, and the people are able to use it as they need to. Right now, we're been slammed with COVID-19. And unfortunately, there are people out there who are hungry. And without your donations, we wouldn't be able to get it done. I give thanks every day to every donor that monetarily helps us. So please continue to help us as much as you can, whenever you can. And thank you.
Hello, my name is Hope Walsh, and I'm with the Love Inc. Board of Directors. We are excited about you joining us today for our virtual fundraiser. Love Inc. is a redemptive ministry, joining God in His work in our community. As the Lord leads you, we are looking forward to you joining us in this opportunity. May the Lord bless you and our services now as we give you that opportunity via the virtual auction of joining that in that work. Thank you.
Thank you, Hub. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to tonight's auction event. My name is Greg Jones, and I've been involved in the fundraising auction here for quite a few years, but this year is just a little bit different. Instead of giving you 30 seconds or 60 seconds to bid on an item, you actually get 2 weeks. But we have some great items tonight that we're going to give you the chance to bid on, but we just want to let you know tonight that whatever you do tonight, you're not spending, you're giving. God says in Luke 6:38, He says, "Give, and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and overfloweth into your bosom." So the same measure that we use will be given back to us. So let's stop and think. We're sowing seed, and we're giving tonight, folks, and you're not spending. If you stop and think about it, everybody's going downtown, buying items, buying gifts, buying vacations. Why not write the check and sow it in good soil to Love Inc. and get that same great item? So what we're going to do is announce the items that we have for you tonight, but remember, you have 2 weeks to keep the bidding going on them. Hey, how about listen to this? Anybody hungry after dinner tonight? How about Jantz Pie? And listen to this, not one time for the year, but Jantz Pie once a month for a full year. Everybody loves Jantz Bakery. Thank you to Jantz Bakery. Hey, listen to this. How about a vacation? Tahoe Meadows Cabin in Lake Tahoe. This 2,700 square foot home has 5 bedrooms and 4 bathrooms and sleeps 10. This log home is across the street from the lake. The home is located between the ski run and the casino area. Heavenly Valley Ski Resort shuttle is located outside the main gate. Available for 2 nights between September 10th and November 20th, 2020. Donated by Cindy and Greg Hubbard. Thank you again to Cindy and Greg Hubbard. Hey, listen to this. It's school time, folks. It's school time. How about an iPad? How about a Wi-Fi 7th generation 10-inch 32 gig donated by Mirco Credit Union? And thank you again to Mirco. Listen to this for you adventurous. How about Tolan Flight over Yosemite in the Merced area with pilot Wes Tolan, donated by Debbie and Wes Tolan for the adventurous? That'd be a lot of fun. Now listen to this. Everybody wants a vacation also. How about Disneyland? Disneyland family pack to see Mickey and Minnie, 2-adult, 2-day hopper passes, and also 2 children 2-day hopper passes also, plus a $100 gift card that you can spend at Disneyland. Expires December 30th, 2021. What a great value there. Oh, listen to this. This beautiful custom-built redwood bench. Take a look at the work in this, folks. And table with 2 decorative pillows created and donated by Tom McCall. Tom McCall has blessed us every year for a lot of years with something handmade, and we thank you again, Tom. Oh, listen to this. Here we go. Walsh Pedroza and Pedroza Dinner. Here's a favorite party deep pit barbecue dinner with 10 with all the fixing provided by Hub Walsh, John Pedroza, and Josh Pedroza. Includes the vegetables, potatoes, salad, and the rolls. And I'll tell you what, folks, these guys will entertain you also. Hey, listen to this now. Sheriff Vern Warnke's famous steak and lobster dinner. Sheriff Vern Warnke's famous bacon wrap filet mignon lobster tail for 8 people. And you never know, if this brings enough money, we might be able to talk Vern into giving you 1 free get out of jail pass. We don't know though. Okay, how about a weekend at Sand Dollar Beach? Enjoy 3 days and 2 nights, Friday through Sunday, in this beautiful 5-bedroom, 3-bath, fully furnished home in the beautiful Monterey Bay. Beautiful ocean views, just a short walk to luxurious hotel, Sand Dollar Beach. What a great value here. So don't forget, folks, there's over 50 other auction items tonight, the silent auction, too. We have gift certificates, 49er footballs, exotic animal training, all kinds of stuff, children's tractors, and private fishing lake alarm systems and everything. And I'd like to thank you right now, folks, in advance for your bidding and your giving tonight to Love Inc., because I had a chance to help and deliver some food to some of these people. And I can see, you know, Jesus talks all through the New Testament about sowing seed. And I can tell you one thing, I guarantee you, Love Inc. is great seed. Great seed to sow into. And he also talks about a 30, 60, 100% fold. So it all belongs to him anyway. But you can visit our website, loveincmerced.com. And here we've got another video for you.
So we are entering the home of Andreas Johnson. She gave us a call about 2 weeks ago, and she shared her story with us about living in D Street shelter and applying for some housing assistance. And praise God, she finally is going into her new home. And so after just kind of talking with her and trying to meet her need,
we decided we really want to share her story and just let you see just how Love Inc. tries to step in and help our families, and how you, the donors and the people that donate to us from the goodness of your heart, can help families like Andreas. So this is her apartment, and this is all that she has. This is the dining room kitchen area. As you can see, it's combined together. She doesn't have a couch. She doesn't have a dining table. And then she has a hallway that leads to her bedrooms. And she lives here with her son. And this right here is Andrea's room. As you can see, this is how she's been sleeping and living. No mattress, just a blanket and pillow on the floor. No dressers. And then this is her son's room, Trenton, who folded up his blanket, but he's also been sleeping on the floor. So as you can see, it's heartbreaking just to see how our families who come to us, the need that they have. Through a home visit, I was able to see just the way that they were both living. At Love Inc., we have a motto: no one sleeps on the floor, no one eats on the floor, no one has fellowship and family time on the floor. And so we definitely came together and said we need to help Andreas and Trenton. Today, you know, by the grace of God, we are able, through donations from our families and from other families and from, you know, local churches that have helped donate and provide for the families like Andreas, today we're gifting them with beds, we're gifting them with a couch and a dining table. So I'm excited for her to see that. So come on, let's get her some furniture. I just want to ask you, like, how has your journey been up until now? I know that you said and you shared that you were at the shelter and now you finally got housing.
It was more than being sheltered. It was, we walk by faith, not by sight. You can lose everything, but as long as you place God first, and I think that's a part of being homeless, is God shows us that we rebuild and start all over, but we refocus. While I was in that tent on my square, what did I have? I have my life. What did I have? I have my son's life. It's taking every piece of every moment in life and things that we don't know about, you know, and on our past lives, on what we could have done to, like, maybe being under the influence of drugs. I was, you know. Everything is taken for granted, and God gives us a chance to restart, rebuild. But His hand, if He keeps it over us, and we pray for that, we can make it. We went to the shelter. We laid in tents on the ground, but I still had my life. You know, opportunity was still there. We still worked while we were homeless. Something we didn't do while we were in the housing part of it. You know what I mean? But God makes a way. He does. And so this is a way of rebuilding. Heard so much about Love Inc. Everything was, call Love Inc., call Love Inc. And then the ink part of it. In the name of Christ.
Yes.
That did it for me.
So, praise God.
Thank you.
Praise God.
Me and my son just got our own place. Oh, please make a great donation to Love Inc. Because without them, you would never have a start. There's people that have said Love Inc., but until it happens to you, you don't know. But look at what they're actually doing. This is beautiful. They're brand new mattresses, you know? This goes beyond what the average person does these days. And so it's not just a name, but it's just a caring foundation, and they care. They do care.
When I first began at Love in the Name of Christ, I had heard about the 35% poverty level in Merced, but now I was seeing it with my very own eyes. I began to go into the homes of our Love Inc. families to assess their furniture requests. My first home visit was a young single mom with two small boys. We walked into the bedroom and she pointed to the corner with a pile of blankets and said, "That's where my boys sleep." It broke my heart. Home after home, it was the same story over and over again. I felt completely overwhelmed by the desire to help these families. So I called Love Inc. National and told them about our situation. And they said, "Annette, go to the body of Christ and ask." And that is exactly what we have been doing. For the past 5 years at our fundraising event, we ask you to help support our fund in need for beds. You can donate $50 or $100 towards a bed on our fund in need page in our auction link. When you think about a bed, it's more than a mattress to sleep on. It's a place to find rest where we can hold and snuggle our children and find warmth and security. Thank you for helping provide more than just a mattress to our families today. And now back to Jake and Bree.
Wow, thank you so much, Greg, for that amazing auction time that we had right now. Thank you, Andreas, for allowing us to share your story. And thank you, you, the one I'm staring at, for tuning in tonight and being a part of making a change in your community. Your faithfulness to be the hands and feet of Christ is what met Andreas's family right where she was. And now they have furniture, they have a place to sleep, and you made that possible. So thank you. We're so excited. Thank you, Linda, for being on. Jay, we've got Jay here giving us some emoji with a face. Jane saying yay. That's so good. If you haven't already, please give us a thumbs up. Give us a like. And if you feel like the message that we're giving tonight is important for your family and friends to hear, share this. Do a watch party right now. And again, if you haven't, give us that thumbs up. Give us that heart because you're in this with us. So thank you for that. Okay. So why don't you tell them what we're going to do next?
So what time is it? It's giveaway time.
Yay!
So first giveaway that we did, if you weren't here and weren't tuned in, we did a giveaway of a dinner out at 510 Bistro. Mm. So we had someone who answered the right question, and now we're doing our second giveaway.
Okay, what are we giving away? What are we giving away?
Drum
roll, please. Drum roll, drum roll, drum roll, drum roll. Boom!
So it is a movie basket. So it has different kinds of candy, popcorn. It has a microwavable popcorn machine that you stick in the microwave.
Let me see. Is that what this is? What is this thing?
Popcorn. Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Yeah.
And then it has two movies already in it.
Oh, is that Frozen?
Yes, that is.
I might keep that. Keep that for my kids. I'm kidding.
And so it has a lot of great stuff for you to enjoy with your family on movie night. So you need to answer this question.
Yes. Okay.
In order to win this beautiful basket.
What's the question? What's the question? Go, 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 go.
The question is, how many churches are currently mobilized that are partnered with Love Inc. in Merced?
Okay. There's the question. There it is. Flood the chats right now. First one is the winner. How many churches
here in Merced are partnered with Love Inc. in Merced?
Yes, come on. Perfect. And while we are waiting for the answers, I think, if I'm not mistaken, we have about 50 plus people tuned in right now. It might be 50 different households choosing, I think close to 60. We are so blessed. We're getting some answers come in already.
Yes.
So let's see what answers. We've got 30 by Gretchen. No. No. I think we got a winner.
We got a winner.
Nadine Washington is the winner.
Congratulations, Nadine.
Yes. Would love to see your face, but that's okay. You're here in spirit, and we appreciate you chiming in. Beatrice, you did get the answer right. I'm sorry. Nadine was just a little quicker. Michelle Sievert, thank you for chiming. Look at all these answers. Look at Bob got 35. Close, Bob. Sheila, you got it. Julie, you got it. Kathy, you got it. Good job. Great participation. Hey, as we transition and as our staff reaches out to Nadine, we'd like to just ask a question. What is something that has been positive that has come out of our social distancing? Comment below. We want to know. For us, you were actually sharing this with me earlier, something that came that was positive that came from our social distancing. Why don't you share?
So in this time, you know, a lot of us have been stay at home and not been able to go out and enjoy some, you know, entertainment outdoors as we've done in the past. Well, for me, I've enjoyed just the family time, being able to slow down and enjoy time with my husband, enjoy time with my children. So like gifts like this, like on the giveaway with the movie box basket, it's just an awesome way to find ways to still connect with your children and enjoy a movie and popcorn. So that's something that I've enjoyed. Yeah. I've enjoyed that family time and slowing down.
Absolutely. I feel like I've been given a blessing in time. And we've been given a blessing. Something that I think that Love Inc. would like to say is this social distancing has given us the opportunity to meet you where you are. You're able to tune in the way that you are. And we're so excited to have this evening with you. We want to keep it going, though. So here's Christina.
My name is Christina Shelton. In 2018, I was living in Modesto, California. I was 8 months pregnant when I lost my housing. I became homeless. I felt my whole world crashing. I felt like a failure. I was so alone. I was put on emergency watch because Ashira was little and she wasn't growing. I was drowning in my depression. I felt like God had given up on me, that He had left me. And I didn't know why. We were mainly living in my car. There were nights I would literally put Ashira in my jacket just to make sure she was warm at night. I lived in fear a lot of the time, especially at night, not wanting to get caught with a newborn. I saw no end to this misery. I lost my job, so my car was really the only option I had. It went on for months. In 2019, I moved to Merced. We started to go to Yosemite Church. I know I needed God. I hadn't been to church in a really long time, but I felt His calling. In March of 2019, I got baptized. There was a sermon that Pastor Jeff was speaking on. And he was talking about how God hears our cries. He hears our prayers. He knows our struggles. I realized that God had been walking with me this whole time. I was reminded that God is our Father and we are His children. He is our protector and our stories are already written in His book. Being baptized was one of the most amazing moments. I was a part of something bigger than just me. That didn't mean that I wasn't still struggling, though. I had a 6-month-old baby. I was still homeless. I was staying in my car. I didn't have a job. I was filled with anger and frustration. I was scared. I was determined to make it work. Easter Sunday came. After church, I went to a tent. I hadn't eaten all day. I was tired. When I walked up to the tent, I wasn't expecting anything, just prayer. I met a few ladies, and they did. They put their hands on me and they prayed over me. And in that moment, I felt God's love and that our struggle was being noticed. One of the ladies went to the kitchen and grabbed me some food. One of the ladies got us an Airbnb, so we had a safe place to stay for the night. Annette invited us to have lunch with her family. We went, and that's when I got introduced to Love Inc., which was an amazing moment. After many, many months of struggling, almost a year, we got accepted into an apartment. Walking through that door, I felt so relieved. I felt like I could breathe. I felt like I wasn't drowning anymore and that it was all gonna be okay. He had finally heard my cries and my prayer, and he was answering them. But he was answering them in his timing. It was just so beautiful. Love Inc. helped furnish my apartment. They helped move me in. I finally paid off my car. I got a full-time job. It was finally ending. He was like, "You're doing it, my daughter. You're doing it." And I was doing it. Ashira had a home. She had a safe place to be. I would just look around and just be like, wow. Coming from just so much struggle, I'm still in awe. God has done amazing things in my life. That is my rescue story.
Hi, I'm Christina. I want to thank everyone for tuning in tonight and listening to my rescue story. Sometimes we can feel like we're so small, and we can feel like we're not important and that no one sees us. As a single mom, you may feel like you're alone, and that can be scary and very stressful. As a parent, all you want to do is provide for your child, and sometimes it's not easy. I want to ask those listening to help serve their sisters and brothers and to see those around them that are struggling, to be their blessing and to be their answered prayer. In my struggle, it was hard to not feel like I was drowning. I wish someone would have helped me. And it was a blessing the day I got to meet Love Inc. I want to ask each of you to humble your hearts and to donate. It doesn't matter how much, every dollar counts. We were set on this planet to show love and to be God's people and to show His grace. Thank you so much and many blessings.
Thank you, Christina, for sharing your rescue story. You might be asking yourself, how can I make a difference? Love Inc. is where it starts. Because of the lifeline of your donation and support, we can become firsthand responders, and you get to be a part of our rescue team. So would you consider a monthly partner gift for $25 a month or $10 a month, or a one-time gift tonight? Any amount will make such a difference in the lives of those who God sends us. Hebrews 13:16 says, "We will show mercy to the poor and not miss an opportunity to do acts of kindness for others. For these are the true sacrifices that delight God's heart."
Amen. First, before we dive right in, Ama, we saw your comment. A member from our staff will reach out to you to get you the help you need. And secondly, looks like Angel wants you to know that we love you, Mom. Angel, that's so sweet. Thank you for giving that shout out to Christina. Christina's story was so sweet, right? And in what we're asking today, in terms of that monthly giving, right, of $25 or $50 or that one-time gift, really, if you think about like the grand scheme of what we're asking, is less than what it would cost for you to go on a date night, right? If you did one less date night, you can provide one more meal, one more bed, one more piece of clothing, and help people like Christina. So please just consider that. Want to give them some more information about our auction?
Absolutely. So we have over 50 more auction items ranging from gift baskets to garden art that you have 2 weeks to bid on, all the way through to August 22nd. Click on the link in the comment section below to view the auction page.
And don't let that item get away at that price. So please make sure that you lock in that bid. Again, some of the fun stuff I saw was flights over Yosemite. Not for me, but it might be for you. Other things I saw, though, were like trips to the beach and cabins. And gosh, Greg could not have said it better. If you're going to write a check, have it be to Love Inc. If you're gonna spend your money, have it go to Love in the Name of Christ, because then we can see multiplication happen in the way that God designed it. We need you. You're part of this plan, and you're part of God's great plan of redemption. So thank you so much for joining us online. Again, this is our first virtual event, so please enjoy our closing presentation with Sandy Smith singing My Rescue Story.
God bless you.
Here I was, empty-handed, and crying out from the pit of my despair. There you were, in the shadows, holding out your hand, you met me there. And now where would I be without you? Where would I be, Jesus? You were the voice in the desert, calling me out in the dead of night. Beat me the battles for me. You are my rescue story, lifted me up from the ashes. You carried my soul from death to life, bringing me from glory to glory. You are my rescue story. You were my testimony.